Microservices are the most scalable way of deploying software, but that means nothing unless you choose the right option of deploying microservices, processes or containers, run on my own server or use the cloud. Do I need Kubernetes? My name is Olga and I'm a product marketing manager at Semaphore. And today we're going to talk about five different options of deploying microservices. So let's dive in. Option one, single machine, multiple processes. In short, buy or rent a server and run microservices as processes. At the most basic level, we can run a microservice application as multiple processes on a single machine. Each service listens to a different port and communicates over a loopback interface. Continuous integration for this option will follow the same pattern. Build and test artifact with CI pipeline, then deploy with continuous deployment. Option number two, multiple machines and processes. So this option is essentially an upgrade of option number one. So when the application exceeds the capacity of a server, we can scale up, so we can upgrade the server, or we can scale sideways, so add more servers. So in case of microservices, horizontal scaling into two or more machines makes more sense because we get improved availability as a bonus. So this option is excellent if you have a few spare machines and want to improve your application's availability. As long as you keep things simple with services that are more or less uniform, like the same language, the same frameworks, you'll be fine. Once you pass a certain complexity threshold, you'll need containers to provide more flexibility. Option number three. Deploy microservices with containers. While running microservices as processes is very efficient, it comes at a cost. The server must be meticulously maintained with the necessary dependencies and tools. A runaway process can consume all the memory and CPU. Deploying and monitoring the microservices is a brittle process. All these shortcomings can be mitigated with containers. We can run containers in two ways, directly on server or on a managed service. Containers on servers. This approach replaces processes with containers as they give us more flexibility and control. As with option two, we can distribute the workload among any number of machines. Serverless containers. Many companies prefer to avoid servers whenever possible because they're not in the business of managing servers. They're in the business of solving problems with code. Containers as a service make it possible to run containerized applications without having to deal with servers. We only need to build the container image and point it to the cloud provider, which will take care of the rest. Either container option will serve small to medium-sized microservice applications. If you're okay with your vendor, a managed container service is easier, as it will take care of a lot of things for you. For large-scale deployments, both options will fall short. Once you get to a certain size, you are more likely to have team members who have experience with tools like Kubernetes, which completely change the way containers are managed. Option number four, orchestrators. Orchestrators are platforms that distribute container workload over a group of servers, and the most well-known orchestrator is Kubernetes. Orchestrators provide extensive networking features like routing, security, load balancing, and centralized logs, everything that you might need to run a microservice application. With Kubernetes, we step away from custom deployment scripts. Instead, we codify the desired state with a manifest and let the cluster take care of the rest. Kubernetes is the most popular option for companies that make heavy use of containers. If that's you, choosing an orchestrator might be the only way of going forward. However, before making the jump, be aware that the biggest challenge for companies that are migrating to Kubernetes is finding skilled developers. So if that's you, the next option might be your best bet. So option number five, deploying microservices as serverless functions. Serverless functions deviate from everything else that we've discussed so far. Instead of servers, processes, or containers, we simply use the cloud to run code on demand. Serverless provides a hands-off solution for scalability. Compared with Kubernetes, it doesn't give you as much control, but it's easier to work with and you don't need any special skills to work with serverless. Serverless is an excellent option for small companies that are rapidly growing. Conclusion: the best way to run a microservice application is determined by many factors. A single server using containers is a fantastic starting point for experimenting or testing prototypes. If the application is mature and spans many services, you will require something more robust. You can also mix and match different options. I hope you found this video useful and make sure to subscribe to our channel as we are going to be sharing more videos on everything CI/CD. And happy building!